Hello, my soccer universe. Boy, this was an evening yesterday, especially for this LASK fan here. Again, I watched my two favorite teams, LASK and Milan, at the same time early on. And yeah, what can I say? At first, it looked all going well for LASK and Milan a little bit struggling, and then it all completely turned around. And yeah, in the end, two victories for me. That was most important, but it was with a lot of nerves, I have to say. In Linz, weather at the moment is horrible. So yeah, and it's probably the last game that LASK will play with spectators in the old stadium before it will be torn down and completely rebuilt into something very nice and beautiful and so on. So yeah, the game started super well for LASK. I mean, within 10 minutes, they were 2-0 up, pressing high. The first goal came within, I think, 100 seconds or whatever, when Raguš played a through ball to Balic. And then suddenly there's just one Ludogorets player and Balic and three more options for LASK, but Balic somehow isn't controlling the ball well. And the Ludogorets players can't get ahead of him, but he takes just a shot from outside of the box and it goes in. Yay! Great. And yeah, this game caused a teeny bit of friction since my wife is from Bulgaria. I tried to explain to her that Ludogorets is basically the least liked club in Bulgaria and, you know, not that many Bulgarians in there anyway. So yeah, she understood. We were fine. We did not fight in any way. So I thought, yeah, everything going well, but then already a little bit, I mean, maybe Trauner was fouled, he admitted it, you could have lost, but then a bit too much of, not concentrated ball comes to Santana, plays through to Manu, who puts it into the net, and it is 2-1. And then the game that was so much going in LASK's way gets a little bit more even, and you could see that Ludogorets is in the game. And I have to say, again, the high pressing of LASK and the technical abilities of Ludogorets played well into each other. In the end, it was LASK that actually could get the upper hand towards the end of the first half, and Raguš with a very artistic goal made it 3-1. So I thought, yeah, my nerves are eased, it will be fine. Right after the half, LASK really comes out storming again. And Balic, it was one of numerous, takes a shot that is twice deflected. In the end, it's Verdon on goal. And it's 4-1. And here, then they made the crucial mistake. They wanted to kill the opponent. And there was no need for it. You were up 4-4-1. You could have calmed down the game a little bit. But, you know, on the other side, the LASK game is not for calming down. It's all for pressing forward and going full on power. And, yeah, out of those one, I mean, then you take off Gruber and Balic. I understand that because you want to bring on Goiganger and Egger. Goiganger is a perfect player to kill off a game because he can keep the ball, hold it up, because he was not that great. But in principle, and Eggestein, you want to give him some, in-game experience that he finds his footing there as well. He has been great so far. But in a way, the game then broke on a counter-attack. And that was always going forward so intensely made them vulnerable on the back. And Manu, again, after a pass from Santana, runs free on goal, and if you see it in the replay, he is really waiting on the touchline. Felipe, which is not out, and runs on goal. Schlager has his hands there, but it is 4-2. Yeah, not much happening yet. But then again, such a counter, and this time Grgic, who that will hurt, is on his back, and he tries to kind of save it, but ball hits his hand, although he then denied. No, I never. Please, if you did it, go for it. He's sent off with a yellow-red, and that, as I said, will hurt because Holland is out with an injury, and now Grgic also out. I'm not sure who will be playing in the defensive midfield at the moment. Penalty, Manu 4-3. A man down, but to be honest, there would have been... They held together, and they could actually keep Ludogorets at bay. In fact, it was Goiganger who missed a great chance to make it 5-2 that would have settled the game and settled my nerves considerably. 5-3. But yeah, 7-goal game, Ewald, what do you want more? Unfortunately, as we'll see, it was soured by Antwerp winning over Spurs. More on that a little bit later. Milan, on the other hand, very much business as usual. A very, how to say, non-hurried, going with your game plan, going forward, knowing that Sparta Prague is the weaker team, so we just need to put a normal performance, even if we play not the first team squad. Yes, Zlatan was, of course, in the lineup. First off, I didn't understand why Milan is playing with black shorts and white socks. I mean, either go all black down, but not this weird look. That, again, I think, I know where UEFA did it, play in white shorts and have Sparta play. It worked against Roma this Monday, so, but you know, UEFA doesn't like these things. Anyway, Ibrahimovic sets up Diaz, who probably could have won time, but actually made a smart thing. Stopped it, turned around, took a shot, took a slight deflection, but went in. 24th, 4th minute, Milan well on their way. Then a great pass by Kia onto Krunic, where the goalkeeper could save. Ibrahimovic is brought down in the box, and of course he steps up for the penalty. And why is Ibra still taking penalty? Maybe there was no Kessie this time because Tonali was playing, and there was no Calhanoglu playing. So I guess it was all right for Ibra to step up. But honestly, I have to say I'm getting tired of Ibra taking penalties. He wants to aim high, and it goes over the bar. He hits the bar, and yeah. He came off at the halftime. You could see how he could not believe that he could not. I mean, Ibra is great for Milan. Yes, he assisted the equalizer for Roma, but he also scored two goals. He's great for Milan, getting everyone ready. But on the other side, step down your ego a little bit. Have seen, by the way, the spot where he says everyone in Milan should wear their mask because the coronavirus took on me and I defeated it. But you're not Zlatan, so protect yourself and the others. Ridiculous. But I love Zlatan. I really do. I really do. Even before he went to Milan. In the second half, you know, Leao Kauka comes on. And then it's the Portuguese show. Dalot assists Leao. Goalkeeper could have maybe gone a little bit more clear out. But other than that, the pass by Dalot was wonderful. And Leao just punches it home in the 57th and 67th. A really nice deep ball from Benacer into Dalot, takes the shot, deflected, goes in. Milan 3-0, easy win, and also top on the group because the other two teams only played a draw. So I would say we run through the games like we usually do, and then we'll see what's happening there. We're going a little bit in reverse order because I want to do it chronologically, but so we start with group I through L and then go to the next one. So we had Karabakh, Villarreal was long time nothing. The 78th, Karabakh gets the lead, but then Pino and twice Alcázar turn around for Villarreal to get the win. Sivaspor loses home despite having a lead to Maccabi Tel Aviv. We talked LASK. Antwerp wins against Spurs. Yes, Spurs again playing a second string squad, maybe even more so than LASK, And then one thing, thanks Jose for valuing LASK, but on the other side, please. And, you know, the Belgian league is one that I consistently rank higher than the Austria league, and Antwerp is playing up there with Club Brugge. This will be not an easy game for LASK, and I'm not happy that they now have the away game first and after playing Sturm. Antwerp totally deserved that one, should have won higher. Rafaelov gets the winning goal. Honestly, they should have won by 2 or 3, and yeah, Jose was not happy with his team in the press conference, and it might have been it for Dele Alli, because he was one of those, maybe in Bergwijn and so on. So yeah, but even with Kane and Son and Lucas up front, he cannot win it. That's, yup. It angers me a lot. It angers me a lot because that was not necessary. A draw, okay, but a loss, unacceptable for me as a LASK fan, and considering Spurs to be by far the best team in this group. CSKA and Dynamo play out a 0-0 draw. Not much happening there. Feyenoord against Wolfsburg is a result that was all down to the ref. This was not... Wolfsburg beat Gladbach last season 4-0 away from home. This was not one of those performers. This was the referee going completely AWOL. Maybe the first, you couldn't see the first penalty for Wolfsburg, that this may have been. There was a little contact, but it was very nice fall. Lindl steps up. But the second one, there was absolutely nothing. And the referee had just been shortly appointed because the refereeing crew, the original one, was down with coronavirus. Go figure. Lindl steps up, makes it 2-0 for Feyenoord. Wolfsburg against Feyenoord. Absolute crazy. Then in the second half, Feyenoord comes out storming. Berghuis gets the 1-2. They were storming for getting the equalizer, but then got caught on a counter that Lindl converts, makes it 3-1, and that basically settled it. And then get another penalty, another very, very soft penalty. And it is 4-1 for Wolfsburg. I mean, for Austria, this is a great result. And Wolfsburg at the moment is not that bad. And except for Lindl, I actually like most of those players. So I have, you know, it's great that Wolfsburg is doing great. But referee, give me a break. Hoffenheim, very easy win against Ghent, although Ghent had a chance to take the lead with a penalty, which was saved, and Hoffenheim took then the lead through a penalty. Juventus Vesta completely destroyed Liberec. Then we go to the next set of games. And now we go start with the bottom half, because all those were the early games and the other one were the late games. I know, it's probably not the best way of doing it. Have to think about it. Ajax loses his home to Leicester, as expected, penalty by Warrior Chaudhuri. Clear at the half. Yes, I can put one back, but Leicester gets the win. As does Braga against Zorya, also rather easy win for them, because Zorya gets the goal very, very late. We talk Milan, Sparta, Braga. But Lille against Celtic, that was an interesting one, because Elianussi, by the 32nd, had given Celtic a 2-goal lead within four minutes, those two. And you thought Celtic is going. Then even David misses a penalty for Lille. So Lille completely down, but they come back, which I guess for Milan is very good, with Zelic in the 67th and Ikoné in the 75th equalizing. So yeah, good job, Lille come back. I thought that Celtic, from all I could get, I had maybe a little bit more of the game, but you know, Lille could have easily won that one. Then we'll go to late games on top. Omonia PSV, probably the goal of the evening, was scored by Gomez, who takes, there's a foul given, no one is, you know, blocking the ball, and Gomez takes a shot from his own half, and it lands right into the net. Of course, then Götze to Madueke and Marlen, 1-1 at the half, and yeah, I have the PSV jersey is hanging up there now. Fortunately, the ranking they had of PAOK, which we'll talk in a sec, so I had to put PAOK there. So I'm happy that I have did this one, but I would love to have PAOK up there as well. There. Among my favorite teams here. So, and then the game is kind of slow, and in the end, Marlon gets the goal in stoppage time to win it for PSV 2-1. Granada and PAOK play out a rather dreary 0-0 draw. PAOK once hit the post, but I think that was it. Alkmaar, very easy win over Rijeka. They are flying. Kopemenas with a penalty. Gudmundsen scores two. So, really good. And again, that's a team that LASK disposed of relatively easily last season. So, we have to see. And the other funny thing is that AZ has not won in the league yet. They played the draws, even against Venlo. A week before Ajax beat them 13-0, they played only a draw. But in the Europa League, they got already two big wins. So, very curious what's happening there. Speaking of Napoli, that game between Real Sociedad and Napoli probably was one of the biggest matches in this whole week, because that's the first in Spain against the second in Italy. Yes, it's very early in the season. But still, lots was expected, but I think the game largely did not deliver, I'm afraid to say, and it's decided by a Politano shot that got deflected. Osimhen thought he had the 2-0, but the free kick was played twice. I mean, what a mistake. And in the end, Osimhen is sent off with two yellow cards. So all not that rosy for Napoli, but you get the win. You get yourself back into contention in the group. Actually, a huge win if you consider those two are potentially the best two teams, at least on paper. Another Italian team, Roma, total disappointment. Total disappointment. Yes, Mkhitaryan hits the post, but ZSK well could have scored as well there as a Roma, and then playing in those black jerseys. Everyone seems to love them. I hate them. I really hate them with a vengeance. They are not the worst, but no. Thank you. Thank you. I pass. For starters, a little bit red is missing in there, but also the whole... I have a Serie A jersey review on that. But yeah, Roma totally disappointing. I have to say that they cannot find the win. And yeah, that sets them back a little bit. Cluj and Young Boys play out a 1-1 draw. Both goals late. Young Boys equalizing a Cluj lead. Arsenal has at first a little bit trouble. I mean, Dandel even could have scored maybe the first goal, but then... goalkeeping error enables Nketiah to score the first, and Willock shortly after the second, and Pepe right after half, and the game is settled. Very easy for Arsenal. They can play a second string squad and still get it done. My personal disappointment of the evening, and I know I hate those guys, is Rapid. I thought Rapid should win against Molde, and then Austria would have had a clean slate all wins. Austria should win in Norway, but Molde totally deserved to win that one, totally. That it took until the 65th minute to get the breakthrough, that was rather disappointing from a Molde point of view. And Rapid only hit once the post, but other than that, they were clearly the second best team, which tells me again, Rapid A is more concentrated on the championship, and B, Rapid is not that good of a team. They just get good results due to the counter-attacking football, but once they are favored, they're not that great, to be honest. Slavia with an interesting game against Leverkusen. Leverkusen getting a red card early on. Bellarabi tripping from behind was a straight red. I think okay, but you know, the German Capcom commentators did not like that for sure. Then Stanciu misses a penalty in the 65th minute that Radetzky caused, but then he also saves it. And Ola Jinka in the 80th gets the win that was probably deserved for Slavia. But yeah, interesting stuff happening there. Orge Zenis finally gets a win through a pity. Gets a win 1-0, and then Benfica also takes a little bit more time against Standard Liège, but two penalties early in the second half through Pizzi and Waldschmidt put them on the way. And Pizzi then scores a really nice goal to make it 3-0, and Rangers beats Poznan 1-0. So those were the results from the second match day of the Europa League. Let's look at the standings. Now we run through A through L. Cluj leads the group because Roma cannot get anything. And you know, all draws, so nothing much help. Roma still favored to go through. It's between Young Boys and Cluj, so let's see. And as far as I see, those two will... no, they just played it. I'm stupid. Arsenal... very easy, and Molde now really favored. I mean, Rapid will have a hard time to get out of this group. They will need to get two wins now. Then probably we need to hope that Arsenal is not doing anything and win at home to Molde. So it's a tall order, I have to say. The group C completely open. So it's basically down to rating, which would favor Leverkusen and Slavia. But let's see how that goes. Benfica and Rangers asserting themselves in Group D. I think there is hardly a way back for especially Standard Liège. Group E, another one that's rather open now. The chances are with Granada and PSV, but you know, PAOK has not lost yet there. Maybe they can pull an upset against PSV. Group F also relatively open. They still give AZ the advantage AZ is leading, but the advantage is now Napoli and Real Sociedad. It has to be seen. I think Real Sociedad, AZ, those two games will now go a long way. Rijeka is a little bit out of sorts here. Braga and Leicester cruise through Group G. Milan now in control. They play now twice against Lille, which I'm a little bit wary. But, you know, 4 points out of that one, and Milan should be fine in that group, I think. The Group I is also clear. Villarreal, Maccabi, Tel Aviv taking control there. They're playing now against Getzer, so Villarreal can go through. Group J, yes, Royal Antwerp is now about to play LASK. Spurs still should go through. It was bad news that Antwerp won that one for my LASK. I think they need 4 points against Antwerp, and that will not be easy. Absolutely not easy to get that one. Wolfsburg is leading in Group E. Still CSKA and Dinamo Zagreb are favorite, but remains to be seen. Wolfsburg can pull an upset. And the last group is now Hoffenheim, which I mean as Vesta also makes somewhat sense. The overall favorites, and see it already here, Arsenal now tops it because they have such an easy route out of this group, as seemingly does have Milan. Then Leicester, Napoli, Spurs, Benfica. Villarreal is in there as well. So kind of interesting to see the first Champions League team is now RB Leipzig. That is listed at 9th, and I can sort of see that as well. And I already said, next round, we have a few interesting ones. On the first sheet, I mean, Benfica, Rangers, sounds like a big one. Roma needs to get something done against Cluj. Absolutely. Then PAOK, PSV, I'm looking forward to. Real Sociedad, AZ, Milan, Lille, and Leicester City, Braga. I think those are two really enticing games. I again will watch Milan and LASK. Yeah, for LASK, it's a do-or-die game against Royal Antwerp. Villarreal, Maccabi, Tel Aviv have to play. That's, I think, an interesting one. Dinamo Zagreb, Wolfsburg will go a long way in deciding how Wolfsburg can go. Well, that was it. A long video again, because there's lots of action in the Europa League. Give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Drop a line below if you agree with anything that I say or have a different view. I would like to hear yours. And I will talk to you soon. Bye! If you enjoyed this video, and if you did, here are some videos and playlists that you might enjoy too. Also, please consider subscribing to my channel and hit the little bell icon to get updated whenever something happens in my soccer universe. And with that, have a wonderful day. Bye!